Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about the fullerene in the space elevator. Now probably I'm expecting that none of you know the term fullerene, so first I will explain what fullerene is, second the specialty of the fullerene, and lastly how fullerene has contributed to the creation of space elevator. Now first, the concept of the fullerene. A fullerene is basically a chemical substance that is only composed of carbon atoms. Its shape is like a soccer ball, so if you don't follow me, there's a soccer ball on the ground, and at every vertex of the soccer ball, place one carbon atom each. That is how a fullerene is shaped. Secondly, the specialty of the fullerene. The specialty of the fullerene is made when its form changes into a form called carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotube is basically a cylindrical fullerene, so it's a different form of fullerene from the general fullerene. Now anyway, Edwards Barley-Crowe, who is a principal investigator at NASA Institute of Advanced Concepts, has once participated on a research about carbon nanotubes. In his final report, he stated that a fiber made of carbon nanotube, which has 3 millimeters in diameter, so it's like this, can endure 45 tons. Like, so this bit of fiber can endure 45 tons. So if you don't understand, it's like an elephant on a twig, and it maintains its shape. So it has a very, very big strength, and it can endure very, 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 very big weight. Now, thirdly, how fullerene has contributed to the creation of space elevator. Before, the space elevator is a theoretical structure that can transport people or objects into space. Now, originally, it was theoretical. According to NASA report at 1998, the cable of the space elevator should endure 65 to 130 pascals, which is like a 35 tons, and the cable should be long as the length of a general satellite, and it should be tapered when it approaches the Earth. Now this was impossible until the 20th century. But however, the discovery of the fullerene has made the space elevator to be created. So one day, we may be able to just ride an elevator and go to visit Mars or Moon and see rabbits on the moon. So today I have talked about three things. First, the basic concept of fullerene. Second, the specialty of the fullerene. And lastly, I talked about how fullerene has contributed to creation of space elevator. Thank you for listening.